Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. On Monday, SpaceX launched another batch of Starlink satellites with the Starlink 511 mission.
One, ignition, engines full power, and liftoff of Starlink 5-11. Go Falcon, go Starlink.
The booster which launched this mission, B1073, then landed successfully for the ninth time on the drone ship. Just read the instructions.
Stage 1 landing burn.
Can see that.
Stage 2 terminal guidance.
The stage 1 landing burn has started in preparation for a touchdown on our drone ship. Just read the instructions. Keep an eye out for the landing legs that are scheduled to
deploy
just a few moments before landing.
Stage 1 landing confirmed.
And Falcon 9 has now successfully landed, marking the ninth successful landing for this booster.
Then, also on Monday, SpaceX launched another Falcon 9 rocket with the Transporter 8 mission.
2, 1, engines full power, and liftoff of Transporter 8. Go Falcon, go Transporter.
The booster which launched this mission, B1071, then landed successfully for the ninth time on the landing pad at Landing Zone 4.
We can expect that landing burn to begin in just a few seconds.
Stage 1 landing burn. Landing leg deploy.
As you saw and probably just heard, we had a successful first stage landing at Landing Zone 4.
Coming up soon, we can hopefully expect another Falcon 9 launch. The Satria 1 mission is currently scheduled for Sunday 18th at 9:54pm UTC or 5:54pm EDT. I wanted to share a tweet from SpaceX having hit an achievement with the Transporter mission. It says, Falcon 9 launches the Transporter 8 mission, completing SpaceX's 40th mission of the year and our 200th successful recovery to date. In another tweet, SpaceX said, flight-proven first stages have launched approximately 90% of the last 100-plus missions since the start of 2022. I wanted to share this really cool drone shot SpaceX posted of the landing as well. They said, after delivering 72 spacecraft to orbit, Falcon 9 returns to Earth and completes SpaceX's 200th landing of an orbital class rocket. Here's a sped up version of a cool video SpaceX posted on Twitter showing how their launch cadence has rapidly increased over the years. Heading to Boca Chica, the chopstick catching arms were seen being raised up to the top of the tower. Work continues at the orbital launch site with this water deluge pipe seen being installed. A new water tank that was seen in the last video was moved to the launch site. It was also lifted and moved into position. The other water tank was also seen moved to the launch site. The second water tank was also lifted and moved into position. In the production yard, here's a view of the new high bay with the second level being installed. Musk was asked on Twitter when we could potentially see the next Starship flight test. He responded and said 6 to 8 weeks. Ship 25 continues to wait for a static fire test on the Pad B test mount, which could happen today. Taking a look at the closures on the Cameron County website, the possible closure for today is now a scheduled closure. There are also possible closures scheduled for tomorrow, Thursday 15th, as well as next week with Monday 20th and Tuesday 21st. Finishing today's video, we have two production diagrams to take a look at thanks to the ring watchers. The first is the Starship production diagram featuring Starships 25 to 35. Then there's also the booster production diagram featuring boosters 9 to 16. As always, I have to say thanks to Nick Answeeney for being out there filming the Starbase content. Also, thanks to the NASA spaceflight team working behind the scenes on their videos, live streams, and other space content. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.